Hey everybody, I'm TecToss, and welcome back to Let's Play Divinity Original Sin, my Sunday leisure pleasure game. I decided, last time we really took a brutal beating, there's no other way to put that, against Dithmar and his thugs. And so I had to go back to town, sell some stuff, repair my armor and whatnot, and I decided to take the opportunity to do something that I've wanted to do for quite some time, and that is check Jahan's inventory. Oh, damn. Nope, I forgot. Alright, let's talk to Bear Daughter again. And that is to get rid of Bear Daughter. Because I really don't like that two ranger situation that we got going. So she's gonna get her armor back on, her boots back on, and we're gonna give that stuff to Jahan. We'll keep the poison arrow, though we're gonna get the explosive arrow away and the healing potions. Yeah, she doesn't need the extra healing potions. Resurrect scroll. Sure. Give that all to Jahan, and she doesn't need the 180 gold. That's fine. And also the lore master rings. Keep the battering or bartering. I don't really know how to pronounce that. Armor specialist leadership. Guess that could go to Jahan as well. Alrighty, now we can get rid of you. And where is she? Ah, there she is. Why do we have red hair all of a sudden? You have orange, white, blonde, whatever, but not red. Alright, need you to leave the party for now. Blah blah, there we go. Good, and we're gonna hire a henchman. Now, the two types of characters that would fit really well are a wizard, and we got Explodo the Mythical there, Mystical, who would really make a good damage dealing, yeah, just straight up damage dealer. He does have mostly intelligence, mostly pyrokinetics. He can use high level, well, high level is a big word, but for our terms, high level pyrokinetic skills, and he got a couple interesting defensive skills, but I don't know, he's a little bland, and he's also level 5, so he will never be able to catch up with our party. And for 2000, I think we can do a little better. And the second character that would fit in, and I of course took time off screen to look through all those, who would be the most fitting and interesting. This gal here is a very, very interesting type of character. She's a Shadowblade, and we do need a sneaky rogue type character, but one that could also hold his ground and deal damage. And man, is she an interesting combination. She's a pyrokinetic and scoundrel. Now, the scoundrel part, I don't really like it that much, because you have to have a dagger, so you can only use daggers. So again, we don't have somebody who can use a short sword, and we can't give her a shield to be a little bit more, whatchamacallit, durable. But outside of that, she's got an interesting set of skills, and she has the burning touch. So she gets up close, then she can set fire to you. She can cast wildfire, which gives her extra AP and I think also extra initiative, I'm not sure. Definitely makes her faster, and she can do more in her turns. She could set the ground on fire, and she could also deal a nice damage with these Shadow Blade, or what's it called? The Scoundrel skills. And she could charm a target. So that is a very interesting set of skills. Also the Dexterity Intelligence mix, I really like that. Probably could be more efficient if you combine other skills like Poison and Scoundrel or whatever, but I really like the idea of that, and she's a little costly, but we sold so much of that worthless magical crap that we actually could afford it. So I'm gonna hire her, and she's gonna be my new Bear Daughter. And if I ever pronounce her name correctly, what's that? Duck? Can I please see the name? No, you won't show it? Okay. There we go. Daxalina. Daxalina? Daxalina, that's what I'm gonna go with. And she's gonna get... actually, let's keep the Lore Mastery with Jahan. Lore Master Telekinesis, Lore Master Poison Resistance. Yeah, let's keep it with Jahan. G give that super duper leather cap to our new damage dealer. Same goes for the boots and for that and that. And yeah, Jahan now has level 2 lore mastery without ever spending a point in that. So he's our crafter and lore master, and also telekinesis for whatever reason. But he's mostly gonna be our healing type, with maybe the occasional points spent in Eru Turg. Though we don't need that, we're gonna have Ragnar for that. So he's just gonna be stunning, and I'm not gonna like give him many more skills. He's mostly gonna try and heal us. Now for this girl, let's see, we could definitely improve the armor situation, though not by very much. Could improve the boot situation by a lot. And gonna hide her beautiful hair under this ridiculous cap, because that's just how we roll. What do we have for a weapon? Oh, that is a... wow. That is one sharp fighting knife. Alright, we need to find better bracers and a couple rings and amulets for her, but... oh wait, what do we have here? Strength plus 1. Yeah, that's actually for Ragnar. Keep that here. Orc helmet. Perception plus 1, initiative plus 1. Though outside of that, there's really not much the orc helmet does for us. I guess we're just gonna go with this. And keep the orc armor just as a reminder. Could sell the short sword though. Requires strength 6 and strength 8. What do you have? Strength 5, 5, and 5, of course. Well, at least Ragnar has a correction. He had a nice looking helmet. Now this just looks like a flower pot. Oh man. It's like Captain America's wings grew out too far. And he doesn't even have the shield. Whatever. That's... oh, what am I doing? Walking around. We're just gonna go... we do need some healing potions for our new addition to the party. So let us go to the market and get a couple of those. Like here. I also don't need the remote control anymore. And I could... like, does Llilith have one? You have one and you have none. Alright. Like 6 scrolls of resurrection, that's a little excessive. Don't really think we need that many. 3 should be plenty. And then we're just gonna go with 1 for Llilith. 1 for Llilith. There we go. And 2 for Jahan, and she can have 1 as well. So everybody has Trolls of Resurrection. Llilith has 4 potions. New guy, new girl has 3. So I guess you can have 1 from Jahan. 4 is plenty. He could also heal, so. Now we got 3 there. 4 for Llilith. For Ragnar, I think we're gonna switch to the bigger healing potions. And we could split off a couple of these. Plus 2, maybe. So you're at 5, you're at 4, and you're at 4. I guess we could buy 1 and sell the useless. No, not the equipped stuff. This guy, we don't need that. Yeah, I'm not gonna sell the orcish armor. Though I will... yeah, I'll probably sell the fishing rod and the guitar. I don't really think that there's gonna be any use for that in the near future. So, fire resistance... let's just get 1 regular... ah, let's get 2. Get rid of one of these cups. Maybe both. How's that? No, that won't do at all. Let's balance it like so. Yeah, that's better. Good. Taking my leave. And now we need to get one of these. Okay, so 5, 5, 4, 4. And Ragnar, of course, having the medium healing potions, because He's the biggest, baddest of our party, meaning I've got the most hit points, and he's probably gonna be in the... Yeah, right. Probably gonna take the most damage, so... At least that is the idea. Initiative plus 5. Ooh. I like that leadership. Oh, we need to rearrange the skills as well. Let's give it a quick save. Should have done that after rearranging. Oh well. Good. So Razor's Edge. That's a direct damage spell. Lacerate as well. And Burning Touch. I'll consider that damage as well. Don't need a Staff of the Magi, because it's probably not gonna apply. Alright, so we got the debuffs and buffs down here. And we got the direct damage up here. That looks like it makes sense. Now, where's that Dithmar? He's down here somewhere, right? Love the music. Yep, there he is. Right, let's give it a quick save and say hello to our little friend. Now this time, time over the stuff. Pragmatic, blah blah. All right, so this time we're gonna deal with the ranger first, just so we're gonna deal with both thugs first, just so we don't. Oh, let's actually just deal with the desecration. I'm gonna have plenty of time. 3 points. I could just teleport this guy on top of this guy. That makes sense. Yeah, I like that. Teleport you on top of you. There you go. Enjoy that. And take a step back. Now Ragnar is just gonna hit Dithmar on the head, basically. Could be Shocking Touch. Let's try. This time I failed. Alright. Got that guy. Ow! That kinda hurt. Ah, perfect. Well, that's not too perfect, but... Okay, so what does that give us? Maximum AP plus 4. AP recovery plus 4. Sounds sweet. Let's hasten ourselves up and try... If we run past them like so, that shouldn't... trigger any... Alright, there we go. Invisible, that's okay. I hope he stays with... No, he doesn't. Damn it. Let's go with the ricochet. And just skip the point. Now, who needs healing? Nobody yet. Doesn't heal any... Yeah, we don't have a healing for the crippling effects. I probably need to get that with Llilith. For now, though, I'm just... Well, actually... How much hit points does Ragnar have? Can I see that somewhere? 280. 30 vitality. Yeah, I think we'll just... actually keep the points. And Ragnar, well, can't do anything. What the... Yeah, that made a lot of sense, buddy. That was just great. Alright, so we're gonna try and get behind this guy. Give you a little burn. Burning failed. That's too bad. Oh, just have a regular stab in the back. There we go. Oh, maybe we could bring him. Ah, damn it. Oh gosh, that's what I did not want to see. I could knock down Dithmar. But there's a danger heal. No, we'll just stick to the plan. Switch to precision stance. There we go, 99%, that's better. Very good. We can't hit that guy, but that's okay though. I'm just gonna self-heal for now. And magical claw hold. I don't like a claw hold. How about blind fail? That's okay. Yeah, we definitely need some intelligence boost. The Ragnar is just fine for now, so we could just try and focus on the thug. Ow! Jesus. How many more hits can you get? I'm just gonna run there. And do some stabby. Of course. Okay, that's not the most effective on him. Maybe, no, I'm not gonna. Let's not waste our. Done. I'm gonna keep 2 action points with her. Show your ugly face. This lot's getting more obnoxious by the night. Hey, that's bad. That freaking slowed status is really bad. What the? Did they destroy Llilith's armor? Is that what you're telling me? But... I repaired it! The mother... What happened? Oh... Dexterity minus 3. Well, that is great. So we don't have any... Well, that's just awesome. I don't know how to deal with that. I really don't know. We don't even have the possibility to save up. Yeah, I'll just sneak over here, basically. And save the action points. Well, maybe one more. What's that? A Myelin healing potion? That is rather annoying. And we can't run away with him. Because we're slowed. Do we need a healing potion? And let's just run these 2 steps. And of course we're going to get an attack opportunity, because why not? God, these crippling effects are really, really turning a problem. Should have stocked up on stuff to... Well, whatever. Shoulda, coulda, woulda. No more chance. Gotta be shitting me with these stupid attacks of opportunity. There we go. That's the kind of damage I like to see. No, of course. Well, I guess maybe that fight is just a little too much for us. Ragnar's taking it just fine, but the rest of the party... Yep. Not taking it too great. Let's get out of this poison crap. And see, do we have anything magical? No, we do not. Could resurrect. Bring him up here. That's okay. At least we're making use of these points. But now I have to chuck another potion, and I'm not able to self-heal right away. At least we're gonna be able to... these guys... let's see if we can't kill you. There we go. Very good. That's one down. And there's another one. Maybe we'll just become air. Or teleport. It's not that easy. But I think we're about to take a lot more damage, and we do have lowered constitution, so let's become air. And just give this guy a whack. Smackety smack. Sure. There you go. That should do it. And for you, I have a special skill saved up. Very nice. Oh, come on. There you go. That's the target. Go for Ragnar. Though this minus 3 constitution is a little bit of a problem. Oh man, this fight really not easy. Alright, so finally I'm able to put back on the bow and the armor. Well, at least the bow. Chuck a potion, and we don't have enough points to even do anything with it. We're stunned. Ragnar needs a heal. Yeah, that's that. Do I chug a big potion? Don't think it's necessary. Famous last words, right? If I shock this guy, we're standing in blood all around, so that really wouldn't do as much good. Yeah, I think I'll... safety first. Go for that, and just shoot him a smack. There we go. Alright, I'm just gonna attack him regularly. Miss is good. Oh! Don't want to waste another resurrection scroll. These guys, these things are very expensive. Oh, at least that stupid thing isn't able to do anything. Alright, so now I could ricochet. Yeah, go for that. Who died? One, two. Oh, you died. Very good. This bitch keeps shooting up, but that's okay. We can't heal, though. That's not so cool. He's still stunned. Yeah, if I blitzbolt, very likely that I'll stun. Let's just try and kill that guy. That's enough for now. How about you take a little head treatment? There we go. Alright, yeah, let's first chug a potion, just be on the safe side. And then give that guy 2 whacks. Come on. One more. No! I need one more action point. Hate it! Oh, he's blind, so he can't do much, but... He quaffs a potion, alright. But I really don't, like... Ah, finally, she's Did she hit once during that fight? I don't think she did a single hit. There we go. Now go over here, bring ourselves in a position to actually hit people. Yeah, I'll have to try. Oh, that's great. Everybody's stunned now. That's just awesome. Well. Yeah, that's really not what I wanted there. Everybody's stunned for two turns. What do you know? Blood is a good... got iron in it, so... Oh, man. Well, at least we're gonna get 100% hit bonus, hit chance on these guys. So how about we give him a little burn, like so? Well, actually, I don't think that's necessary. Just regular shots should do the trick. There's one, and we can't do the other, but we can do. Little oath of desecration for a little extra damage. Whew, now give my favorite new addition a little heal. There you go. There's that. Six action points for wildfire. Yeah, I think I'd rather burn this guy. God. Damn it. Maybe a healing potion. Ooh, apparently our become air ran out. That's not too great. Switch to precision stance. There we go. There's that. Ah, that's too far. That's too bad. Right, let's throw that guy on top of Dietmar. There we go. So expensive. It's just a healing potion. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna hold out one turn and then we can set back the thing. And now we could backstab you a little bit. Bleeding failed. Alright, that's too bad, but ow, no, don't go. Oh gosh, that hurts. Well, at least they're spreading out their damage, that's one thing. Ah, finally. So Dietmar's down. I just need to stun you. Hello there. That's very good. How about I just need to come a little closer. Like so, maybe. And you just need to come here. Give that go a smack. Very good. Should be stunned for two turns, so actually that should be game over. And that was a very costly fight. Very, very costly. We chugged like three or four potions. We used the Scroll of Resurrection. Probably shouldn't have fought those guys just yet, but we finally freaking did it. Whew. All right, now let's see. Sharp dagger. That's something for Stuff of Pergamon. Holy. It's another 500 XP. How much? Oh, we still need 8,000. Wow. Alright. We got a little gold down here. It's all just minor healing potions, huh? Well, you get one for you. And you get these two. Come on. One and two. Whew, that was a pretty hard fight. I'm not sure if we actually should have done that. But it's over now, and that's the most important thing, right? Sharp push dagger. What's a push dagger? Poison resistance, whatever. I'm gonna let her collect a little bit of gold. Poison potion. Alright, how about Llilith? Okay. How about Llilith? We'll take these arrows. Thank you very much. Knockdown. Silver. And put back the armor, please. You look ridiculous without it. Like we got most of it. All that's left is a party healing, and let's see if we can't. Hopefully, that dagger is something we can use. Gonna give it to her. Staff of Pergamon. It's actually not that great. It's a little better than ours, but. I don't know what all the fuss is about. Now let's see. Yeah, it's actually worse than the dagger she has. We get a little extra perception. 5% chance to set petrified. Well, that sounds kind of helpful. Though, yeah. Overall, I think the damage potential matters more. So we're just gonna leave her with her dagger and sell that. And also sell the air staff, because likely never gonna use that. Why does she have a bow? Single-handed combat. Armor specialist. Perkinetic scoundrel. Yeah, why does she have a bow actually? No real. Source Hunter's Bow. 42 to 72. Wow, that could actually go to Llilith. I'm not sure what her bow does. That's definitely less, though. Huh. We got the bonus skill point and the. Oh, we got a reputation? Ooh, that's nice. Alright, Staff of Pergamon goes to the boss. Yeah, but all in all, we paid more to win that fight than we actually made in loot. Seems like. What's that? Orange juice. Well, at least we found some orange juice. Whoops! Let's actually save that. I do not want to have to do the fight again. That was pretty hard. Wooden crate. Maybe they got some interesting stuff in the chest. Ripped robe. Alright. That was certainly worth it. Not. Nothing in here. Nothing in here. What the fuck are you? A pincer. Level 5 pincer. Let's see. There's a dead man here. A noble push dagger. Starfish. That's an interesting little spot. Well, apparently it's not that interesting. At least we gained some experience for just... Ah! What is that? Can't I take that? Tiny pearl, yeah, I can. Come on! We take it. There we go. Talk about well-hidden loot. What are you... Chirp, chirp. I guess eventually I need somebody to be able to talk to animals, because... That's just... seems like everywhere there's some animal running around that would make our lives a lot easier if we could only extract the information that it holds. But... we cannot. Well, up here looks certainly peaceful. That's always suspicious. Sealed statues. Oh. Hello. Let's actually heal up first. How's that heal so bad all of a sudden? Like, used to be the shit, and now we're just not getting anywhere with that heal. Takes forever. I guess I need to find what's that? A water mage, and buy a couple better healing spells. Yeah, 34 per turn. Two turns. Still 60 hit points that it heals. Why can't she... What's the problem here? Seems to be some kind of bug. 211... That is weird. She should be able to heal up full, right? You get extra constitution, so... Huh. That is weird. Can she only self-heal now? That can't be it. We could heal her initially. That is really weird. Let's give it a save. Maybe if I reload the game, I'll give her one more try. Yeah, there we go. Now it works. Alright. That made sense. But you saw me heal her like 5 times. Nothing happened. Alright, Ludens. So apparently these are the statues that tell people to jump. I do not want to go in the middle there just yet. Watcher, so that looks like ice. Like water. No, water. Oh, water, fire, air, and earth, apparently. And they do not look very friendly. They got that bone skull stare. Oh god, that guy looks just like... Any of you played Warcraft? Warcraft 3, the real-time strategy game. And the first expansion where the Lich King came. That looks pretty much like him. The turned Arthas, the Lich King. Anyway, we got our waypoint, we got our portal, so I think I'm just gonna go back to town, see if we can't find a better healing skill, and repair our stuff, and then see what these portals are all about. But for the episode, we're done. I hope you enjoyed it, even though it was just one big fight, but it was a pretty tough one. And it was a fun one, especially after winning it, because now Dithmar is dead, we got the stuff of Pergamon, so we can advance that skill, that quest. And hopefully get a little XP for that. Also could advance the Arhu quest as well, the Fabulous Five. So definitely going to do that next episode. Anyway, that shall be it. So hopefully you enjoyed. Hopefully you enjoy the rest of your Sunday or whatever day that is you're watching that. Have a good one. See you around for the next episode. Until then, goodbye.